What's the matter, Admiral Bottom? You're not looking well.
What's the matter, Fat Governor? I'm not very well. I know the trouble, too. Hmm? I'm not getting enough green food to eat.
Well, that's your own fault. You want to dig for victory like I do. I've got a grand allotment. Yes? You know what an allotment is, don't you?
What?
Well, it's where there's a little done allotment. But I've been a bit unlucky with my tomatoes. I entered my tomatoes in the local produce show, and they got first prize in the red currant section. Still, I've been lucky with my celery. I've had a grand crop of celery, more than I could use, really, so I'm giving all my celery blood transfusions.
Blood transfusions? Mm. Well, what are you getting now?
Rhubarb. Of course, the ground's in a terrible state. You know, the ground's all dried up, you see. Do you know the potatoes I've planted? They're coming up as crisps.
But tell me, Governor, what do you find troubles you the most? Sparrows or the worms?
Well, I've never had the sparrows. No, I haven't. No, I find the big trouble of the slugs. The slugs are eating up all my radishes. Go out at night, a lovely bed of radishes. Come out in the morning, slugs are eating them all up.
Well, that's quite a simple thing. Hmm? All you have to do is to sprinkle some salt up and down the ridges.
Not likely. If they can't eat them without salt, they can go hungry. And I've got a new menace now. Enoch's in the next allotment to me. And since he's joined the Home Guard, he goes out practicing every night, throwing hand grenades, destroying everything in my allotment.
Oh.
Well, I've taken up the offensive.
Have you?
I crept into his allotment last night and I shelled all his peas.
But tell me, Governor, how is the poultry farm coming along?
Oh, proper champion. I've tried a new experiment now. I've crossed a hen with a parrot.
Crossed a hen with a parrot? Mm. Well, what's the result?
Marvellous. In the old days, when the hen wanted to lay an egg, it just used to cackle. But now when the hen wants to lay an egg, it walks up to me and says, "Where do you want it, pal?"
But tell me, how are you doing with the pig breeding?
Oh, I've given up the pig breeding. I've sold the pig.
Sold the pig?
Mm.
How much did you get for it?
I bought it for £3.10 and I sold it for £3.
Well, that's bad business.
Oh, but I've had its company all summer.
Let me tell you, my father once raised a pig.
You're telling me.
Aye, and he fed it one day and starved it the next.
Whatever for?
Because he wanted streaky bacon.
Oh, he gets worse.
Governor, West, you know who was really the greatest farmer on earth?
No, who was the greatest farmer?
Christopher Columbus.
Christopher Columbus? I thought he was a navigator.
Yes, I know, but didn't he plough the seas and plant his foot on soil?
Oh, I'll tell him. Come here, my little sunflower, I'll tell him. Who was the greatest farmer?
He, I don't know.
There you are, he doesn't know. Well, you've heard of Columbus, haven't you, Christopher? You know Christopher.
You mean the chap what puts the gramophone records on?
Oh, no, I'm talking about Columbus, the farmer, do you see? He was having a bit of trouble with the soil, it was too dry. When he planted peas, he had to put them in three at a time. One to shoot, one to sprout, and the other to come up. Oh, look. Anyhow, one day he was mucking about in the garden, and he got his wireless aerial mixed up with a stick of rhubarb and got Mr. Middleton.
Back to the land, back to the sand, back to the grand open air.
The horses had hay fever, which made them cough and sneeze.
The chickens all have chicken pox, which makes them ill at ease.
And a couple of the dairy maids have both got duck's disease.
On a lot of day farm in the country.